I felt that. I honestly feel that logic is correct.
Could be.
Because now you get to side out your defensive card, you're like going second defensive cards, and get to swap to multi-purpose defensive cards.
I've been recording this whole time.
Okay. Well,
Welcome, Sebastian Sanchez, top 32 duels, third place after Swiss. Only had to win one, won both day two, so that was pretty hot. What were you playing? And yeah, just run through it.
I played Swordsoul Tenyi. Just felt that it was the best deck to take into the event. But I felt the Despia deck was complete garbage.
Why? Oh, who put you in your place with that?
I was getting absolutely bodied Thursday night by Raul playing the Swordsoul deck.
If you were playing Swordsoul before, Despy had said you'd still get bodied. It doesn't matter against Raul.
And no shaman, and bodied me so many times. It was
Raul's just built different, but yeah.
I'll just get into the list real quick. It's not going to take long. It's pretty simple. 3 Moe, 3 Longwan, 2 Taiye, 3 Ecclesia. If you play 2 Ecclesia, you're a bozo.
Interesting. Why? We see a lot of people cutting the third.
There were times where I just opened Long Yuan and nothing else. I very much want to play as many starters as I can. Tenyi's, super simple. 3 Ashina, 3 Vashuta, 2 Adara, 1 Shitana. I only ever did this card once to fucking like overkill, pop my own monk with Baxia, bring it back off this.
Mm.
But that was sick.
There's only 2 Adar?
Yeah.
Felt you were missing a third? Or
I banished both off desires a decent bit, and I...
never looked back?
And I banished one off, I would banish one off desires and then go through the other one the following turn, so like I kind of wish I had played 3, but it's whatever.
Do you think you'd make that change maybe forward, or what's your sentiment? Or I guess we can cover that later.
No, I'll get to it when I get to the other.
Okay, that's fair.
And then just Ash was my only monster hand trap. Just something general purpose. Stop Brand Infusion for the spells. Triple Emergence, trying to see as many starters as possible. Droplet, because I'm not trying to get Calamities. And then the only time I played Punk, he Calamities me. 2 Desires, Konami has finally realized the correct ratio.
Yeah, why only 2?
Yeah.
It's nice having Konami build your deck for you, isn't it?
The worst card on my deck, 2 Vessel. I saw it 4 times. 3 of those 4 times, it was a brick. But the 4th time
are we about to see the best card in the deck?
The 2nd best card in the deck, Circle. I wish it had just been 3. This guy's crazy. He played no Circle.
Still made day 2.
I never did it the like dodge imprint play to search Shoshana with it, but like I would attribute my guys off to like acquire value, or like I did the biggest brain play I did was I'll say insane. Best card in my deck, Talents. I resolved it 6 times. It won me the game all 6 times.
Nice. I see you won with the same desires ratio, so that's pretty smart.
Yeah. The big brain play I did.
Right? Yeah.
It won me a game. I talents looked at my opponent's hand, saw he had evenly, and I had just searched blackout already. So I just went set circle instead. My opponent shotguns battle phase. I'm just like circle tribute off my Vashuta, and now all I have is a Chi Zhao, so I just lose the monk, and he's my opponent waste their battle phase. It was sick.
What did you take with the talent?
I won against one of the striker players that made.
That's not
30.
What he asked.
Oh,
what did you take with
the? Oh, I hit the Vashuta, and then I asked his Ecclesia, and I his evenly was dead, and he didn't top deck the answer.
Explain why you set the circle.
To big brain my opponent.
Because you searched blackout.
Yeah, because I searched blackout.
So he's probably just staring at your Vashuta Mung Chi Xiao set 1.
It's about cooking this.
Yeah, exactly. He didn't put the evenly back. He's scared of Vashuta. Like, he's just going to lose. That was hot.
Every time I resolve this card, I won. It's like I took a Baron to force a Chi Xiao. I big brain my opponent by knowing when he was playing. I played against one of the striker players that made top 32. Game 1, he Veilers my Moe. So I'm like, look at his hand. Hit the Mystic Mine out of his hand, so now he's just on striker cards, and I can outgrind him from there.
Mm-hmm.
And then the sick thing, game 2, I make Baron, but he has 1 unknown in hand, so I have to play around Nibiru the whole time. So I Baxia his Link, and his Raid comes back, so I just go, I'll take it. And he summons Kaina, and he gets Kaina effect. So he stops my Baron, and I got like a Baxia. So I like do the math, and it's just like his 15, my 23 Baxia. I make Draco Berserker for exact game. And kill my opponent with his own Kaina, but like this card was sick.
Mm-hmm.
If it's sick, why only 2?
Because I want to see it some of the time, but not all the time.
Fair.
That makes sense.
Valid.
Only when you need it.
Exactly.
It's like the correct desires ratio. It's just some of the time, but not all the time. Called by the Grave. One almost every time I saw it. 3 Imperm is the only other hand trap, and Blackout. Some people play 2 Blackout. I don't.
Hey, you do it.
Ishik. three monk, went through them all the time. Shaman, made it every now and again. Never made Yazi. Making Chijia first every time. Make Baxi all the time. Only made Berserker like four times.
My son's been on Baxia. That's the most absurd card in that extra deck. Baxia is disgusting.
I made Baxia, and then I made Baxia again, and then I did both effects, and my opponent picks it up and reads it, and I'm like, neither of those effects on once per turn.
Dude, it's amazing. Yeah. Baxia is like 2014, the epitome of 2014.
Yeah. Chao Fang, only ever made it once, but like had it with Blackout, so it's like pop my opponent's Brave Token and his Adventure, and then search Ash Blossom to negate his Fusion Destiny. Made this level 10 the most by far. Disgusting.
Mm-hmm.
The draw two play is gross. I only made that like 3-4 times, but it let me game my opponent one round by like 150. This card. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention when I did the whole talents play with taking my opponent's Kaina, the last card in his hand was Nibiru, and I held this the whole time for it. It was sick. And then this card, which should have been Babuska, I never made it. I had the line to make it once. My opponent dogwooded me, so I just gave him like 10,000, 11,000 life. And if I had made this with one of my 10s and the Adara, I could have just gamed him right then and there. But unfortunately, I didn't see the line. But yeah.
It would have been hot.
Yeah, it would have been really hot.
Shout out to the one guy playing Dogwood, I guess.
Yeah. Did you get bodied by that guy?
Yeah.
But yeah, only change is that should have been Babuska.
That's fair. Where'd you get the idea for Babuska?
Brothers telling me right after I submitted my deck list.
Oh, that's fair.
I wonder where Justin got it from.
Yeah. side deck, two crow, buns. I felt I beat Despia normally anyway. Three barrier, didn't actually see it that often, but it was like nice when I saw it. Three anti-spell was crazy. I played two striker, Despia.
Didn't you play Thunder against a Swordsoul who decided not to play anti-spell? He's like, yeah, it's just not that good against like Flunder. It's like, what are you thinking? Like, that card's disgusting.
Three evenly, yeah. This card's crazy. Dark Ruler, it was alright, and Reboot. I only got D-barriered once all tournament. It was crazy.
Reboot or D barrier? Oh yeah, that card. I lost a reboot during the tournament.
But yeah, this
set reboot too. So yeah, sorry to catch that at the end there. So the DD Crow, that was probably what the weakest card in that side deck.
By far, I wish that had just been like another like Lightning Storm or another Hard Go second card. Or like Droll and Lockbird. That's what it should have been. Droll and Lockbird.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I mean, that's a pretty concise list. What was that? Perfect 40.
42.
Nice with the two desires. That makes sense.
Yeah.
All right on top. Yeah, we can run into, do you have any notable rounds, anything you want to talk about? I know we were talking about as we were going, but anything that stands out?
Of my 11 rounds of Swiss, I played, four of my opponents made top cut. So my bracket was pretty stacked.
Yeah, it sounds like it.
Yeah.
Any notable shout-outs?
I made a small list. Shout-out to Justin Brothers and Nick Avarello for the list. I literally just played their list card for card, and it was disgusting.
Apparently not Babuska.
Except for the Babuska. I only copied their list. I forgot that. I didn't have it in my binder.
Okay.
I'm just like, you know what? I want to see if I game someone with Punisher. Shout out Nick Ortiz for also topping the event.
My deck's insane.
Yeah. Hey, yo. Ryan Fletcher for not topping the event.
Oh, God, though.
He's not recorded the whole time. Javi for forgetting to put Circle and Vessel in his deck list. So he played. He day-tuned with neither.
Shout out to Shoshana.
Played two Blackout. Donnie for hooking me up with the room. Jad for being in the room. Raul for dumpstering me on playtesting when I was playing Despia and convincing me to play this. And then just Alejandro, Ricky, Michael, Steven, Brandon, and Nick Jadasing for just being cool guys and texting me and like cheering me on and stuff.
Awesome, man. Well, we definitely appreciate it. Obviously, well-known renowned player around Florida. Nice to see.
Twice.
Yeah, nice to see you back on the scene actually doing something.
YCS?
Yeah, this banter is great. Everyone loves hearing this. So I'll just call it there. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.